This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the title from the 2019 movie Terminator Dark Fate. I provided this image of a video glitch that you can download. Its link is in my video's description below or in my project files. Before we begin, if I've helped you in Photoshop, please consider joining my community of patrons on Patreon for as little as $2 a month. Click the Patreon card at the upper right or the link in my video's description below. First, let's colorize the glitch. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Solid Color. In the hexadecimal field, type in 1, 3, 4, 900. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Change its blend mode to color. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. I provided links to the two fonts that we'll be using to create our title card, Campton Bold and Terminator Real NFI. The fonts aren't exactly the same as in the actual movie, but they're pretty close. Once you install them, click the Terminator font. Make its size 77 points, the aliasing smooth, and center alignment. Click the box, and when the color picker opens, type in 52 three times. Click on your document and type out Terminator. To adjust the spacing between characters, click between the characters and press and hold Alt or Option and the left or right arrows on your keyboard. Double-click the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is chisel hard, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 4 pixels, and the soften is 0. The angle is minus 90 degrees, and the altitude is 30 degrees. The gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is normal, the color is white, and the opacity is 50%. The shadow mode is irrelevant since its opacity is 0. We'll convert our visible text into a smart object so we can add filters to it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Make two copies of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Double-click an empty area of the middle text to open its layer style window. Under Advanced Blending, you'll notice that the red, green, and blue channels are all checked. Uncheck the red channel and click OK. You won't see anything different now, but you will in a minute. Double-click an empty area of the bottom text layer to open its layer style window. This time, uncheck the green channel. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. The angle is 0 degrees, and the distance is 75 pixels. Notice the color of the blurred text is a reddish-violet color because we unchecked the red channel of this layer in its layer style window. Make the middle text layer active, and repeat the Motion Blur filter by pressing Alt-Control-F on Windows or Option-Command-F on a Mac. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your Move tool and press Shift and the left arrow key on your keyboard, which moves the blurred greenish layer 10 pixels to the left. Make the bottom text active and press Shift and the right arrow key, which moves the blurred reddish layer 10 pixels to the right. Next, we'll add a soft, bright highlight in the center. But before we do, let's save some space in the Layers panel by collapsing the Motion Blur filters. make the top text layer active, and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. Make the size 900 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow 100%. Invert your colors by pressing X on your keyboard to make white the foreground color. Go to the center of the text and click once. We'll confine the highlight to inside our text by making the highlight into a clipping mask. To do this, press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Next, we'll create the rest of the movie's title. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Press T on your keyboard to open back your type tool. Click below the Terminator text and click the Campton font I provided. Type the words Dark Fate. Highlight the text and change its size to 33 points. We'll widen the spacing between all the characters by clicking the character paragraph icon or by going to Window and Character. In the Tracking field, type in 960. We can close the panels now. Open your Move tool and drag the text to approximately here below Terminator. Next, we'll add the same soft, bright highlight to Dark Fate. Go to the highlight layer and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it above the Dark Fate text. Then, clip it. Lastly, we'll add a small bright red circle behind the word Terminator. Click the top blurred layer to make it active, and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. Click your foreground color to open the color picker. Pick a bright red color. Press B to open back your brush tool and change its size to 200 pixels and its hardness to 50%. Place your cursor in the center of Terminator and click once. If you want to center the title over the background, click the bottom blurred layer to make it active and scroll to the top. Shift-click the top layer to make all the layers that comprise our title active. Then, press V to open your Move tool and drag the title to the center. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.